Our fifth story out front now is a controversial ad that many say is hateful toward Muslims. It will be showing up at New York City subway stations next week. And here is what it reads. In any war between the civilized man and the savage, support the civilized man. Support Israel. Defeat jihad. New York's Metropolitan Transportation Authority tried to reject this ad, but a federal judge ruled it free speech and forced them to put it up. Out front tonight, the woman behind the ad, Pamela Geller. I asked her why she's doing it.
Well, there have been a series of anti-Israel ads that have been running for years in the New York City subway system and New York City Metro Transit and across the country as well. I submitted my ads when anti-Semitic ads were running in the subway last year, September, and my ads were rejected. And, you know, the First Amendment protects all speech, not just ideas that we like, but ideas that we don't like, because then who would decide what's good and what's forbidden? The government? Violent rioters? So we sued. My organization sued. My law firm, American Freedom Law Center, We triumphed. And it was a triumph for First Amendment, because it wasn't just the fact that my ads had to go up. It was that the judge ruled that their regulations and standards were unconstitutional. So Monday was the day. Next Monday is the day they're scheduled to go up. I'm running them because I can.
All right, so you can. But does that mean that you should?
Well, why should we allow only one narrative out there? I think we need to talk about this. The fact that there's been such a visceral reaction to these ads, and particularly in the media, it, to me, speaks to a much larger problem. Mm-hmm. The problem is this increasing Sharia. The blasphemy laws under the Sharia says you cannot offend Islam. You cannot criticize Islam.
But when you say one narrative, I see your ad, and I see the same narrative that an anti-Israel ad would have. It's a narrative of hate.
Really? I have to tell you, I think any war against innocent civilians is savagery. I think the tens of thousands of rockets coming into Israel from Gaza, targeting homes and schools, is savagery. I think the murder of the Fogel family was savagery. I think the blowing up of a bus in Bulgaria, Jewish women and children on holiday, is savagery. I think Daniel Pearl's beheading is savagery. I think that there is...
But why call a whole religion savages?
How am I doing that? There's no Islam in the ad or Muslim in the ad.
Okay, but the word jihad actually means struggle, and technically in the Quran, to improve yourself, to make yourself a better person. It doesn't mean just going out and suicide bombing people.
Well, I beg to differ.
But that is what the word means. It means struggle.
Actually, in the Quran, there nothing speaks to a spiritual struggle. It's all holy war. And the jihadists that are committing jihad are citing Quranic chapter and verse as a holy war.
And they may be, and I don't think that there's anybody in that religion, right, people who would say, okay, I'm all right with that. The vast majority of Muslims would say that our religion is a religion of peace and tolerance and love, just like Jews would say, or Christians would say.
But Christians are not beheading people and slaughtering people in the name of Christ, and Jews are not doing it in the name of Hashem. There is a faction. There is a very significant faction of devout Muslims, jihadists, that believe in this. Now, clearly all Muslims do not sanction jihad and do not sanction what's going on, these violent protests. But I will not abridge my speech. I will not sacrifice my speech so as not to offend savages.